Our life would be so much easier if we could just take a pill and forget about what we need to eat for the rest of the day. But are these supplements a good replacement for the nutrients found in fruits and vegetables? And can we get everything our body needs from the supplements we consume? In this video, we're going to make some comparisons between the nutrients found in supplements versus those that are found in fruits and vegetables, so that at the end of it, we can decide together how to treat supplements and what part they have in our diet. First, let's talk about absorbability. Taking nutrient supplements is not about how much of it you take in, but how much of it you actually absorb inside the body. There are a couple of things that affect the way supplements are absorbed in our body. First, the vitamins and minerals coming from a supplement are isolated, meaning they don't come in a whole package with other substances they need to interact with in order to be absorbed better. In the book Supplements Exposed by Brian Clement, he explains this matter very well. Extracting a vitamin from its full spectrum matrix eliminates the necessary cofactors that assist in the functioning of that nutrient. Correct vitamin activity can only take place when all cofactors and components of the vitamin complex are present and working together synergistically. Vitamins cannot be isolated from their complexes and still perform their specific functions within the cells. Vitamins have a relationship with hundreds of other molecules, and they need to work together to be active and do their job. Natural vitamin C, for example, is a whole food complex. It's not just the ascorbic acid you usually find as a vitamin C supplement. The complex also includes bioflavonoids, copper, J, K, and P factors. Inside the fruits and vegetables, there are lots of substances that work together to better be absorbed in the body. When we isolate the mineral or vitamin, we're already absorbing less of what we would have if it came from natural food. Now, we covered the importance of interactions with other molecules and cofactors, but it's also important to look at the actual molecular structure. And by the way, guys, for some of you, it might seem like getting too much into chemistry, but I'm going to make it simple, and I felt like it's really important we should understand what we're actually putting in our body. A lot of supplement companies use the fact that most people don't understand or don't research these concepts, and they're misleading people with ads and fancy labels on their products. So the molecule itself of many synthetic vitamins and minerals is not the same as the natural form of the nutrients. And there's actually a study that was done in 2002 comparing between natural, synthetic, and partially synthetic molecules. The researchers found a couple of differences, but the greatest difference was in the number of chiral centers the molecule has. They found that natural molecules have 4 chiral centers, whereas the synthetic only has 1 and partial synthetic has 0. And why is it important? Because the chiral center has a lot to do with the binding sites of the molecule, and therefore the type of reactions it can make with other substances it comes in contact with. Missing those chiral centers can be an issue because those molecules won't be able to easily interact with the right molecules or with other molecules in general in the body, and therefore won't be absorbed very well. They won't be biologically active. The next issue when relying on vitamins and minerals from supplements is that we miss on a lot of other essential things like fiber and phytochemicals, which are powerful antioxidants and cannot be found anywhere else in our diet other than in fruits and vegetables. You'd be missing out on a ton of important compounds like chlorophyll, polyphenols, lycopene, and more. It is always best to get the nutrients we need from whole foods. Supplements may be useful when they fill a specific nutrient gap that is not being met by the intake of food as part of our diet. But if you do need a supplement with a certain nutrient, make sure to look for the naturally occurring standard label on the bottle or send an email to the company. Ask them about the product. Ask them if they use synthetic chemicals during the production process. Synthetic vitamins are much cheaper to produce in a lab than the naturally occurring ones, the naturally occurring vitamins that are extracted from plants. So you want to be mindful. Don't blindly take the first bottle you see on the shelf. Ask questions, demand of these companies to have higher standards and produce higher quality products. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any other questions or topics you'd like me to cover, let me know in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video.